Yo, what is up, everyone? Tooltips in Power BI. They can be really helpful, but not all tooltips are created equal. If you've ever wondered why your visuals in your report just kind of slow down a little bit, it could be your tooltip strategy. So today we're going to compare modern tooltips versus report page tooltips and see how each does impact the performance of a visual. So you know what I like to do? Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. I've created this report. I have a blank page here, and the blank page is because I want to capture like a baseline. I want to make sure all the caches are clear. If you don't know about all the caches that's available in Power BI, Marco Russo and I did a video called The Tale of Two Caches. You should go check that out. So what we're going to do before we get going, we're going to turn on Performance Analyzer and we're going to start recording. And so I have three pages here, and we're not going to worry about this page for now. A modern tooltip page, a report tooltip page, and this is actually the report tooltip that's used by this page. Okay, everything's clear. All my caches are clear, and I'm going to choose modern tooltip. We'll see what happens over here in Performance Analyzer. So we run this, and I've made these measures intentionally slow just for dramatic effect. And so this is just my year slicer over here, and this is just the text box right here. But this is actually this line chart. And so you can see if I hover over this line chart, you can see I have a couple of extra measures. And so I'm going to press stop just so we don't grab any additional queries. And I'm going to go to build and select that line chart. And you can see down here, I have two tooltips selected. So whenever someone hovers those tooltips, they're displayed. Okay. The challenge though is if we go back to Performance Analyzer, we're going to copy this query. And we're gonna open up DAX Studio. And so we're all connected to our model. I'm gonna paste this query in. Let's take a look at this query. So here's my filter from my slicer. But you'll notice that in my visual, there was only a single measure, but you see two other measures here. And you're like, why? Why do I have these two measures? And they actually have ignore wrapped around them. And so you'll see right here, this one is gonna be displayed. And these two are the tooltips. But if those measures are slow, if you start stacking up measures, whenever that visual renders, all those measures are also included in the initial query because they are used when people hover. But Patrick, what if no one doesn't hover? Do I still pay the cost? Yeah. If you use a regular tooltip, you absolutely pay the cost. Let me show you how costly it could be. So I'm going to turn on server timings. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to clear the cache when I run this. So I'm going to run this query and you're going to see lots of stuff going on here. It's not just the queries for my measure that's being displayed, but you're also going to see the queries for the other measures that are part of the tooltip. Those are costly and that's what's slowing this thing down. So we're going to go over here. We're going to clear Performance Analyzer out and we're going to choose start recording. So I modified my report. So same line chart, but what I've done is we're going to run this. You see how fast? And he's like, well, Patrick, it's cache. True. So I'm going to copy the query. I'm going to go over to DAX Studio just to be fair, right? Just to be fair, I'm going to paste it in. And what you'll notice is just that measure. It's not the other measures because I'm going to go back and show you there's nothing in that tooltip area on the build section. And so we're going to choose clear and then we're going to run this. And so when I run this, you'll see that it's really fast. Just a couple of storage engine queries, not as many as this one because it's not executing those other measures. And if we go back over to the report, if I go over here to build, you'll see there's no tooltips. What I did was I created a tooltip page. So let's do this. Let's go over here before we start hovering. I'm going to create a new query to the same connection and I'm going to turn on all queries. It's like a trace. Okay. And so anytime I hover, it's going to execute the query. So let's go over here and start at the end, right? You can see my tooltip. And if we go again and again and again, it's executing some queries. So if we go over back to DAX Studio, we're going to turn this off. And we'll double click here and you can see, right, it's sending individual queries. So if we go through this more, you'll see one for test two and test three, because that's the measures that I use in my report page tooltip is passing the filters. And what that means is the only time anyone incurs the cost of executing those measures is when someone actually hovers. So if no one ever hovers, they don't have to pay for it. It's free. So I'm deferring the execution of those queries. All right. Before you just put it in production, before you start adding tooltips to that tooltip section, make sure it's not affecting performance. Do the test that I showed you here and it will definitely uncover some insights. All right. What do you think? You ain't questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric, Power BI, it's a video flying above my head. And as always, from Martha, Adam, and this guy, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.